Hey, tennis fans, I'm Grace Carter, and this is Tennis Now presented by Technifiber, the official racket, string, bag, and accessory of the ATP World Tour. The 2017 season is over for Novak Djokovic. The world number four confirmed that he is officially pulling out for the rest of the season to recover from a right elbow injury that's been bothering him for about the past 18 months. In a Facebook Live post from Belgrade, Novak said that several doctors and specialists have advised him that rest is pretty much the only remedy.
I have consulted many of the doctors and specialists and various people from both ends of the medicine in the last, 12 to 15 months, and especially in the last couple of months where I felt that injury is getting worse. And they all agree that I need rest, that I need time.
And that means he snaps his streak of 51 consecutive Grand Slam appearances, which, by the way, is the third longest active streak of Grand Slams played and dates back to his major debut at the 2005 Australian Open. So he's going to miss the U.S. Open for the first time in his career, a tournament where we've seen him in the final in six of the last 7 years. Nole says he will not pick up a racket for at least 2 months. But he did also share some good news. His wife Elena is expecting their second child in September. And Andre Agassi has committed to working with Novak once he returns in 2018.
Andre Agassi is committed to stay with me next year. I want to thank Andre for being this year with me. And obviously sharing his experience, his wisdom, and I'm looking forward to get back on the practice courts with him, and of course having him in the box for any big tournaments.
Agassi played some of his best tennis after age 30, and he told Omni Sport that he believes Novak Djokovic can do the same. In a new essay Maria Sharapova wrote for the Players Tribune titled "Into the Unknown," Maria talks about her comeback. She says it's been both a physical and a mental challenge, trying to bring up her level of play and also fend off colleagues who slammed her. Maria says she does not obsess over social media validation like she claims many of her colleagues do. She says they have a habit of checking Twitter right after a match, even before they take a shower. She says she doesn't do it. It's just not her way. Several players, you'll recall, have publicly opposed the wild cards that Maria had received in her comeback. In fact, some have been very vocal. Maria admits it stings, but she says she insists on taking the high road. Jeannie Bouchard, who called Maria a cheater, went on to beat Sharapova in a very intense match in Madrid back in May. Asked this week if she regrets her remarks, Jeannie told Canada Sportsnet, "Of course not."
You're comfortable with what you said.
I am. Yeah, I got asked a question. I couldn't answer it not honestly.
Of course.
So for me, that's how I try to be.
Sharapova's return to the tour in Stanford comes next week, where she joins Victoria Azarenka and Madison Keys at the Bank of the West Classic. This week, a couple of Jets collided on Court 7 at the U.S. Open. The NFL's New York Jets, that is. Running back Matt Forte and linebacker DeMario Davis squared off for a charity exhibition match. After a pre-match prayer, the guys hit the court, with each player putting up $10,000 and bragging rights on the line. Great offense beat great defense in this match as Matt Forte dished out a bagel, winning a $10,000 donation from his teammate for the Matt Forte Foundation, which tries to change children's lives through education. Great program, looked like a fun day. And finally, Grigor Dimitrov has been a busy guy. Last time we showed you Grigor and Rafa practicing at the Rafa Nadal Academy in Mallorca. Well, 26-year-old Grigor also squeezed in some R&R in Italy with his main squeeze, 39-year-old pop singer Nicole Scherzinger, according to the Daily Mail. Very cute couple. The article says she was helping him get over his fourth-round loss to Roger Federer at Wimbledon. Looks like they had a good time. That's the news for now. I'm Grace Carter. We'll see you next time here on Tennis Now.